Ryan Gosling. This is the Oscar-nominated actor that you know. And this is the Ryan Gosling you don't know. This is Biography. Take a listen.
I don't know what the answer is. I don't know how to answer it. I mean, I keep getting asked in interviews, you know, what happened?
Ryan's accent, American, Canadian, it's hard to pinpoint, but it does say a lot about him. Growing up in Ontario, Ryan says he got picked on as a kid. To cope, he decided he needed to toughen up. And to Ryan, no one was tougher than Marlon Brando. So he copied Brando's iconic dock worker sound. The Brooklyn accent not only helped Ryan survive bullies in the Canadian schoolyard, it helped him throughout his career. When he was 11, Ryan moved to Florida to join the Mickey Mouse Club, where he shared the stage with Justin Timberlake, Britney Spears, and Christina Aguilera. When the show was canceled, Ryan moved back to Ontario to focus on acting. By 16, he was in Hollywood chasing his dreams. It wouldn't take long for Ryan to make a name for himself. Despite the new surroundings, Ryan said the Brooklyn sound stuck. I have a phony accent that I can't shake, so it's not phony anymore. His wise guy accent would help him land some tough guy roles, including a drug-addled schoolteacher in Half Nelson, a manipulative criminal in Fracture, and a stuntman turned getaway driver in Drive, all the while refining his best Brando.
I have this thing that since I was young, I've just been compelled to make films. And I'm always trying to figure out why. You know, I feel like every movie will help me understand it.
Real or not, finding his voice helped Ryan grow up and become a star.